Hello everyone, my name is Void Doctor and welcome back to another episode on the Infinity Craft server. And today we're starting off this episode in front of the storage hall because, to be honest, I haven't been making a whole ton of off-camera progress. Aside from a tiny bit of mining over at the Ocean Monument, just taking it out bit by bit. And also a bit of landscape restoration, just filling in creeper holes, replanting grass, things of that sort. I haven't been making a whole ton of off-camera progress. Oh, okay, I've lied. I actually completely forgot I did this. I just remembered I had done this. No, I've also been experimenting with moss mining, and this has been super cool. So I didn't realize it, but you can actually insta-mine moss with a hoe. And being that you can bone meal moss and get moss blocks from that, it provides two benefits. One, it pretty much strips away all the stone, which is it's kind of a negative for me because I really like stone, but that negative also turns into a positive, which I'll explain in a sec. But stripping away all the stone means it leaves all the ores because moss doesn't actually grow on ores. Secondly, you can compost moss to make bone meal, which, if you remember, you can use to spread moss, which you can use to get more bone meal, which you can use to... Okay, you get it. It pretty much is a self-sustaining cycle, which is really cool. Like, the concept of a self-sustaining bone meal farm is awesome. So I've been taking my moss and just putting it in this simple little bone meal composter over here, and I've already gotten 60 bone meal, which is way more than the bone meal that I put into growing the moss, which means it's actually giving me, like, bone meal profits, which is super cool. And I also just have a bunch of bone blocks, so even if I wasn't producing bone meal, I could still get the resources that the moss mining provides. So it provides ores and bone meal, which is awesome. But other than that, I haven't really been making a whole ton of off-camera progress. So, because there's nothing more to recap, I think it's time we do a bit of building, because there's a few foundations, or I don't remember how many foundations, one or two, over on the west side of Westhold. That's kind of funny, but yeah, on the west side of Westhold that I just haven't really built up yet, so I think we're gonna build them up in the form of a third person time lapse, just ease into the episode with a bit of a time lapse. So enjoy the time lapse. Alright folks, welcome back, and I hope you guys enjoyed that time lapse. And I'm actually really happy with how this building has come together. Aside from the floor, obviously, which doesn't exist. But I'm really happy with how this has come together. Originally, I was planning on this being some sort of like chapel or something. But the more I look at it, the less it looks like a chapel because it just, I don't know, something about it just doesn't give off the vibe that I thought it would. But it definitely still looks cool, and I think it looks better than if I'd gone for more of a chapel slash church aesthetic. So I'm happy that I didn't really go for that aesthetic. But yeah, I'm just happy that I was also able to use deep slate, which is something that I wanted to use a lot in the town, but I kind of never really ended up doing. So the more deep slate I can use, the happier I will be, because yeah, as you can see from the earlier builds, deep slate tiles, and then I kind of moved away from the deep slate tiles, although we kind of went back to it with the inspection hall, but that was, I really wanted to use it as a roof trim, so not really sticking with my original ideas for the town, but it's fine. It doesn't really matter as long as I'm happy with how the builds have come together. However, the next thing I want to work on is something that I've really been I've kind of been a little nervous about, because I don't know how you all will think of it, but I want to move on to a new project. That doesn't mean we'll be abandoning Westhold. In fact, we'll come back to it in at most 10 episodes. But I just want to start a new town. Now, this is going to be a pretty different town. This isn't going to be like Westhold. And I want to make use of the new 1.18 mountains. So this all kind of ties in with what I've been doing recently, specifically the ocean monument, because my idea for this town, or my idea for the build style at least, is like a sort of Nordic inspired, almost like a mountain sort of village, but where I have prismarine as the roofs, because I really like prismarine roofs. And I would have used them last season, which was my original plan, but I never really got around to raiding any ocean monuments. But now that I have raided an ocean monument and we still have plenty of time left in the season, I think we could do something really cool with a, you know, mountain village in some high peaks, or maybe just a, I don't know, some sort of village in a mountain valley somewhere. So what I'm going to do right now is just sort of scout around, just fly around, see what sort of mountains I can find. Whoops. See what sort of mountains I can find, and hopefully they're 1.18 terrain. If they're 1.17 terrain, which will be shocking if I can find 1.17 terrain that really blows me away more than 1.18 terrain, then that'll be shocking. But hopefully I can just find some mountains that really look cool and would fit a town. So I'm gonna go do a little bit of scouting, and I'll get back to you with the progress update. Okay, so this is one of the weirdest anomalies I've ever seen. Now, I've been playing Minecraft for almost 10 years, so this is, you know, this is a weird anomaly. We're in an ocean! What is going on here? Someone please explain to me why a decent chunk, wait, is this the entire island is like this? Oh my gosh. Please explain to me why most of this island is in the ocean on land. Is it like the tides have receded or something? Is there some sort of Minecraft lore I'm missing here? Or is it just some sort of like chunk generation thing? I don't know, but it's very strange. Ooh, wait, this is actually really cool. This spot right here. Ah, wait, there's that forest right there though. That could be a bit illusion breaking to have like a forest right there. That looks really cool down there. But yeah, as I was saying, it could be a bit illusion-breaking to have a forest right there. But maybe we could have little outposts and things stretched around the mountains. Oh yes, this spot was meant for this. This spot just spoke to me like nowhere else has. This place is fantastic. Okay, this is definitely where we're going to build the town. So I've actually brought stuff for another portal. I didn't bring a flint and steel. Lovely, lovely stuff. Am I right? Just... Well, we're just gonna have an obsidian ring here, I guess. Lovely stuff. And I'm gonna go grab flint and steel, and we're gonna light this portal. Okay, so I'm back at the site with a flint and steel this time, and we're gonna light the portal and see where this takes us. Oh, wait. What? Oh, I've been here. This is actually super close to the portal. Look. Right. Over here. Yep, there's the portal. The other portal's up there. So it's only like a couple hundred blocks apart in the Nether. We'll take, don't mind if I do. But yeah, this is super close in the Nether. So that's really nice because it means we can transport items to build the place quite effectively. And that makes building this whole place very easy. Wait, I don't want to go through this portal. But now we're going to head back to Westhold, and I'm going to assemble some sort of build palette so we can just get a sort of rough build style and maybe a few houses started here. Because, this again, I want this to be a larger village. Not a giant village, but a larger village. So, let's get a little build shulker box set up. Or actually, probably going to get multiple build shulker boxes set up because I'm probably going to be using quite a few stacks of prismarine here, and I don't want to keep transporting prismarine, so I'm also probably going to gather some spiritual. I'm just going to do a bit of resource gathering and assemble a few build shulker boxes. Okay, so I've gotten a bunch of shulker boxes ready, and it's pretty simple stuff. Logs, prismarine, stone, and just some glass and buckets and stuff. And now we're going to make our way over to the build site, and I want to figure out what exactly I want these houses to look like, because right now I don't have a clear direction I want to go in with these, but I feel like there's a style that I'm leaning towards, but I don't exactly know what it is, so I kind of want to figure out what that is this episode. I swear there was ground there, but I knocked a piglin down there, and rest in pieces, buddy. Okay, so the first thing I want to figure out as well is just I want to figure out where I want to put houses. Like, I'm obviously not just going to be able to, like, slap them down in a flat space of land, because there isn't much of that here. So maybe we can, like, put them on stilts and stuff. I feel like that would be cooler. Not stilts, but, like, sort of hanging off, like, cliff faces and stuff, or hills and things. I feel like that would be cool. And just sort of have it feeling like the houses are sort of not fully grounded, because I feel like that aesthetic is pretty cool. I just realized I forgot to bring a bed. How lovely. Maybe it would just be wise to bring some wool in case I need to craft beds or something like that. That'd probably be a good idea. Okay, I'm really liking how this sort of foundation is looking. It's very rough sketch, right? Like, this is obviously not what this whole place is going to look like. This would be disgusting if this is what it looked like. But I like this little rough sketch here. It looks cool. Also, does it trigger anyone else? This is just kind of a random fact about the game. That when you want to make an L in the game, like an L-shaped house, one of the, like, walls needs to be an even number. And then you need to have an odd number if you want the house to be odd numbered. It just triggers me so much. I don't know why, but it does. I also just remembered I really wanted to build with stripped dark oak. I never gathered dark oak. This is just a lesson why you should always think about what you're building with before you actually go and gather the resources. Does Void have enough dark oak? Yes, actually. That's very good. Very nice. Okay, I really like how the dark oak kind of contrasts with the spruce a bit, and then the spruce will contrast with the strip spruce and the dark oak, or the strip spruce that I want to use for the walls will contrast with the regular spruce logs and the dark oak. So this should look really cool. Now I gotta wait for it to snow again to cover up my little terraforming marks here. Okay, I'm actually really liking how this is looking. I think the contrast between the dark oak and the spruce just looks nice, and also the shape of this house just looks pretty cool. So I'm gonna build up the walls and put a roof on this place, because the roofs here are what I'm really excited about. The roofs are the main point of this whole project, of this whole, you know, like, new town, is really to find a really out there color scheme, because next season I'm pretty much gonna be abandoning this entire, like, concept for a town, like this entire architecture style. So, like, because I have a really different idea for a base, so, like, this is kind of my last opportunity to try a different, like, you know, kind of Northern European, or sort of a different European architecture style until future seasons, because I'm not going to be building in a European architecture style next season. Ah, yes, sleeping on some scaffolding. Lovely stuff. Or sleeping on a floating foundation. friend, it's not personal, but I know your unlightning struck cousins have a lot more respect from me, but like, it's nothing personal. I think I just saw one snow particle just fall from the sky. That's lovely stuff. It might start to snow soon, please. Cover this up. Oh, it's a bee. It's a bee. It's like the little pollen particles. Okay, that makes sense. So yes, we're definitely going to need to make those supports a bit bigger, probably, in the fullness of time. Maybe put some trapdoors around them and things. But right now, I'm really liking how the house itself is feeling. It's definitely feeling quite majestic, and it doesn't even have the giant blue prismarine roof on it. I am going to have to contend with the sounds of goats for the rest of the time I'm building here. This is going to be tough. Okay, I think the next port of call is that I'm going to need to put a roof on this place, but I don't exactly know how yet. I just don't know why I chose to build it in an L, because you can't really effectively put roofs on L-shaped houses, so it's going to be a bit challenging. One stone cutter trip later. Okay, I'm really liking how this little roof section's coming together, so I'm gonna build up the rest of the roof. Probably not in the form of a third-person time-lapse, to be honest. I was gonna say in the form of a third-person time-lapse, but probably not. I was originally going to have, like, goat pens around the village, like, you know, little goat kind of corrals, but then I remembered that they can do that, and that kind of killed my dreams of having a goat farm, like a goat farming town up in the mountains. That would have been really cool, but yeah, I don't think that's really gonna work. So the more I look at this, the less I like the positioning of these stilts. I think I might move them out and just extend these, make these stilts dark oak, because it just makes more sense to have these much thicker stilts and still have these beams here. But the more I look at these sort of like beams that are holding it up here, the more it looks just impossible for this to exist. But other than that, I think the roof looks really cool. So I'm going to fill in these gaps here and, of course, finish up the stilt. And then we'll move on to just kind of finishing up the sort of landscape around here, that kind of stuff. So I logged on and I accidentally had my shaders on from when we were recording the time-lapse because, you know, settings carry over between accounts. And the sky! I don't know why, but the sky feels so blue. It's so pretty. This is fantastic. And with the blue roof and just being in these snow-capped mountains, this is stunning. I want to live here in real life. I want to live in this house on this hill overlooking this valley here and just exist here. I want to live out the rest of my days here, even though that would be a lot of days to live isolated in the mountains. I want to... Oh, no, I'm out of food. I'm so sorry. Oh, no, that you ruined my beautiful stargazing. I have to go get more carrots in the nether, or through the nether. I have to go through the nether to go get more carrots. This is going to be very dangerous, and I still have my shaders on. That's probably a mistake. Okay, I'm really liking how this is looking. I think it's really nice looking build. And I put the door over here on this side. I was originally going to put it on the sort of front facing side, but I thought I'd put it on the side because I think it just looks nicer and it adds a bit of it, you know, it's not something you'd expect to see every day, so it looks cool. And I added these little fences here, or the little fence gates, and I think those look really cool too. But I feel like it's missing something, and I think the thing it's missing is some sort of just little wraparound porch or some sort of little deck here, some sort of awning, or it would be like an awning here and a deck up here. That I feel like that's what it's missing. So I'm going to add just some sort of little sort like railing around this house, and that'll pretty much be it. And this is kind of like our template for the rest of the town. Oh, also, I think it's really funny that if you go up here, since all the prismarine roof is slabs and stairs, but these little end bits right here that kind of come up a little bit higher, those are technically full blocks, even though they're just two slabs. They're just technically full blocks, so they're the only ones that have snow on them. I think I'm probably going to put string up there, but right now it adds... Actually, I might not. It adds a pretty cool aesthetic, so it just makes it look like, you know, it's a slipped, snowy environment, so I might not. It makes it look more like a mountain town. But I'm just going to add this little deck, and then we'll pretty much be done. With this one house, not with the whole city. The whole town's gonna be pretty big. But, you know, this one house will be done. Oh, and say hi to my friend, the snow golem. He's been providing me with snow to replace a bunch of snow that got destroyed in a creeper explosion. So, yeah. Thanks, man. Okay, I'm super happy with how this has come together. It's not exactly what I envisioned. I kind of envisioned it coming up around here, but I think this looks better. It makes a bit more sense to just have a stairway sort of coming up around the house, and I also think this stairway just looks quite nice. Like, if I grab my rockets here, which I only have a few of, see? Looks quite nice. And it also adds a bit of contrast since it's oak wood. So, yeah, I think this is definitely a better decision than just adding a deck. So, pretty happy with how this has come together. And I'm really happy that we've finally started this project. This is something that I've been wanting to work on for a while. So now that we've finally started it, I am so happy. And we are going to be continuing this for the next few episodes at least. So, I think this is actually the perfect spot to wrap up today's episode, as we've pretty much completed every project that I wanted to work on in today's episode. So, as always, my name has been Void Doctor. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode as much as I enjoyed making it. If you did, please like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.